The question in this video is, how long can something work on a battery? That's a completely open question. So here is the title, how long can, say, a LED flasher, and that's the demo circuit here, work on a battery? But it doesn't have to be a LED flasher, it can also be an incandescent lamp, an electronic circuit that takes a certain current during a certain time. That's the most important thing. And this is the demo circuit. It's very, very simple LED flasher. And this is again the schematic. And you see that milliampere meter here that I have, say, wired into that circuit, and it's here. And when we look closely at the circuit, we see that during the flashes a kind of fierce current is taken and it falls down to another value. So that means that you have to get a kind of idea about the current that is constantly taken. And I have taken for this example, say, 10 milliampere. And here you can see what happens exactly. And the whole circuit is supplied by a 3-volt battery. And here is a kind of big problem. Many batteries that are available everywhere don't have an indication about the current that they can give out during a certain time. I tested it. You see some of them. The Maxell 9-volt battery, carbon zinc. And here is a battery of Varta. That's a very good brand, by the way, in my opinion. And here we have a Maxell Alkaline. Here we have batteries of Ansmann in Germany, X-Power. And here we have a 12-volt battery from a Dutch brand. It gives out 12 volts. And here we have again the same battery. None of these batteries tell us how much milliamperes they can give out during a certain time. Normally, when you buy a lead acid battery, they tell you how much energy it can give out during a certain time, say 40 ampere during 1 hour, or 100 ampere during 1 hour, etc. And that's more or less the key issue here. In this schematic, the circuit takes, say, approximately 10 milliampere. And here we have the calculation. But of course there are always problems, because during a certain time the voltage, here's the voltage, could be everything, could be 6 volt, 3 volts, 9, 12, 24 volts. Here is the time. During a certain time the voltage drops down to a lower level, and there is on a certain moment such a low voltage that the circuit does not want to work any longer. And that's important, and that could be a reason why there is no indication here at all about the precise properties of these batteries. So how long during what time all these batteries are able to give out their nominal voltage, say 1.5 volt, 6 volt, 12 volt, and when is the moment that the voltage drops down to say a critical level and it's no longer the specified voltage that the battery can give. And for such a circuit, it's not very critical. This also will work on, say, at 2.7 volts, approximately. But there are, of course, say, circuits that are critical regarding the voltage that they need to work properly. So, the problems, none of the batteries tells us how much milliampere they can deliver during, say, 1 hour, or 10 hours, or 100 hours. So that's unpredictable here. Anyway, in this example, the circuit uses, say, 10 milliampere. And that means, say that the battery gives out 10 milliampere during 1 hour. The circuit will work for 1 hour. And that's more or less, of course, not always, because Ohm's law is valid and the battery depletes, so the voltage goes down, but anyway, kind of rule of thumb, when the battery had an indication that it can deliver 100 milliampere during 1 hour, it will work for 10 hours. And when that battery is 1000 milliampere, so 1 hour, sorry, 1 ampere each hour, it will work for 100 hours and say 4 days. Again, it has everything to do with the curve, say the voltage curve on which the battery acts during the longer time. And you can make calculations in accordance for, say, other electronic circuits, other situations, other types of batteries. Often you read on a car battery, it is 40 ampere hour. That means that it, in theory, can deliver 40 ampere during 1 hour, or 1 ampere during 40 hours. But that's theory, because in cases of lead acid batteries, the battery cannot be depleted too much. Say it can be depleted maximum to say 40%. That means that there is a voltage drop in a lead acid battery. There is a critical, say, lowest voltage where that battery will keep its good properties on the long term, etc. But of course, with all these batteries that are not rechargeable, we can throw them away during, say, after use. And well, that was more or less all to tell. Again, an overview of the batteries. So, well, there is, in fact, not so much to say how long an electronic circuit will work on a not rechargeable battery. It depends foremost on the current that circuit takes and on the voltage where that circuit has to work and where the critical voltage is, where that circuit does not work any longer. So, here the batteries again. Beautiful batteries, by the way. And all these batteries have, by the way, different properties. This is, for instance, a carbon-zinc battery. And that's the most classical battery that you can find in terms of development. And say
a classical carbon zinc battery has this kind of a curve where it gets depleted, where the voltage drops down. But there are also, there are also batteries, and especially rechargeable batteries, that have a kind of this curve. So during say 1 hour or 2 hours, the voltage stays exactly the same, and suddenly it drops down to zero. And here the black line is, say, the type of battery, say nickel cadmium or so. They have a kind of this depletion curve, but when you want to be sure, study the data sheet of the battery, go to the World Wide Web, study your charger, the charger that you want to use, etc., etc., and say the decharging curve is very important for the purpose where you want to use a battery. And like I told earlier, in general, these batteries are not used for critical purposes, but could be that they are used in critical purposes, and in such a case, study the data sheet of the battery or do some experiments, try and test. The carbon zinc battery is, by the way, a cheap alternative for a circuit that needs a very long endurance, because the depletion curve goes very, very slowly down to critical low voltage, lower voltage. And also that is the case when it's not a 9-volt battery, but a 1.5-volt carbon zinc battery. And all batteries, when they get depleted, you get a lot of corrosion here. The acid in the battery will, say, can eat up all the wiring here. And that's very important to remove depleted batteries out of devices. There could be so much corrosion fluid flowing into an electronic circuit that it gets completely damaged. Anyway.